it seems very clear from the testimonies we heard and the videos we saw that Rabbi Aryeh Levine really has a gift in making people feel cared for, and his genuineness in caring for others, in helping others, really shone through in the stories of Rav Aryeh going to the prisons every week. But that is not the only thing that Rav Aryeh did to keep himself busy. He was the mashkiach. He was part of a yeshiva that for decades, a school, that for decades he looked out for the boys, for teaching them, for growing them into wonderful human beings. So he did that for years upon years, in addition to going to the prison. As well, he took on another role. He would visit the leper colony in Jerusalem. There was a hospital there that was for lepers. You can Google it. It's a very bizarre disease, but people who had leprosy were literally isolated from the rest of the community. And Rav Aryeh would make it his business to go and visit them, to learn Torah, holy words with them, to make them feel important as well. So much of his life was given over to the community. The last piece that I want to talk about with Rav Aryeh Levine, again, is an intersection between Jewish history, Zionist history, and this wonderful man. This story happens in 1948. In 1948, right, we talked about the State of Israel is created, we're immediately at war, and a lot of different battles are going down. Now, there's one part of Israel, interestingly enough, the part that I live in, that is annexed off. Nobody can reach it. There are communities of Jews and Arabs living near one another. And after 48, everything sort of collapsed. And 35 soldiers set foot one night to reach this community, or the community across the street from me, to bring them supplies and to bring them food. And unfortunately, they were caught along the way. It is a fascinating story, I tell you now. We spoke about the Lamed Vav, the 36 righteous men. Interestingly enough, this story is the story of the Lamed Hay. Lamed for 30, Hay for 5. 35 men, 35 soldiers who were brutally murdered on their way to help out Jews in this area. And after a number of months, they got the bodies back. Now, after 35 of them, many of them were able to be identified right away. But again, they weren't living in the era of DNA testing. There's no quick cheek swab or skin test to do to figure out who is who. And they were left with 12 remaining bodies, which they could not identify. Right? They knew all 35 names, but they had 12 names and 12 bodies, and they didn't know how to match them up. And they did something interesting called the Goral HaGra. The Gra was a rabbi who lived many years previously, and they took the practitioner who was able to sort of ask God's advice. You pose a question to God, and then using a specific Bible, either their own Bible or it seems that there is a specific Bible, you would open up and you would, it seems to be random page turning in order to get your answer. And then the verse that you put your finger down on, that seems to be the answer that is given. Now, although it's attributed to Rav Eliyahu, the Gaon of Vilna, that's the Gra, it seems to be that this has been in existence, this spiritual, mystical pursuit has been around for over 400 years. People have written about it, but it seems that not anybody can do it, but you need to be a great rabbi with a specific issue at hand, and that's the rabbi that can then approach God with the question, trying to find the answer. Now, the chief rabbi of Jerusalem, listen, this happened in 48. The bodies were only returned in 1951. So really, we're looking at corpses and not bodies. 23 bodies could be identified. The other 12 could not be identified. The chief rabbi at the time was a rabbi named Tzvi Pesach Frank. And he thought that we could identify the remaining bodies by doing this Gra lottery, opening the Bible back and forth, looking at different passages and different verses until we could discover who each of these young men were. Now, the identification took place with Rav Aryeh Levine was the one who did it. It took place in the Beit Midrash with representatives of all of the bereaved parents, all of these parents who just wanted to bury their son's body with the proper respect. 12 candles were lit. The Bible was opened 7 random times. And then Rav Aryeh ruled that as they stood in front of the remains of each fallen fighter, the last verse on the page that he picked from the 7 pages going back and forth, the last verse on the page had to include the name or some kind of allusion to the name of each of the people that they were trying to identify. Now, how amazing was it, and I'm quoting here, how amazed everyone was when one of the verses that first appeared said, "The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and the world, and they dwell within." And the word "the Lord" begins with Lamed Hey. So here we are looking for the 35 with the Hebrew word Lehashem, which is also Lamed Hey. The first verse, one by one, became very easy to identify each young man. Every page that he put his finger on, every verse that he reached, literally had the name of one of the boys that had been killed. This was a very, usually it's done very privately. People don't talk about such a thing. But here's one instance where this mystical pursuit really garnered this ability to give kavod hamet, give the proper respect to the dead, and to give some amount of comfort to the parents who were finally burying their sons. So if we look back at who Rav Aryeh Levine was, we see this man who maybe was one of the 36 righteous in the world in that time period, a man who moved from Lithuania to Israel, who then took on leadership roles in Jewish schools, at the prison, at the hospitals, and finally who gave solace to parents for children that they had lost in 1948. I cannot recommend enough reading more about this guy. I have included articles at the bottom that you can link to easily to learn more about Rav Aryeh Levine. You can Google him. There is so much out there on him. There's a movie there. This is somebody who you want to learn about and learn from. He is truly an awesome man in our awesome series of lectures. Thank you all very much. It has been a pleasure. Bye-bye.